Hello and welcome, dear children. Today we shall study standard 7th English, unit 4, poem number 4.1, Under the Greenwood Tree, written by William Shakespeare. William Shakespeare is regarded as the greatest dramatist in English literature, and his song has been taken from this popular comedy play, As You Like It. In this play, a character named Amiens, who plays a role of a courtier, has sung the song Under the Greenwood Tree. This is a beautiful song in which Amiens, a lord in the forest, is there who follows Duke Senior and is encouraging people to leave the busy city life and enjoy the lovely, wonderful life in the greenwood trees, which is no less than a paradise. So, before a further delay, let's get started. Poem number 4.1, Under the Greenwood Tree. Under the greenwood tree, who loves to lie with me and turn his merry note under the sweet bird's throat. Come hither, come hither, come hither, here shall he see no enemy but winter and rough weather. In the first stanza, the poet is inviting all of us by singing a song. He is so happy to be in the nature under the greenwood tree. He is listening to cheery song of a bird full of joy. He also tries to imitate the sounds made by the bird. In the second line, the poet says, who loves to lie with me. Here, Shakespeare has used a key word, that was lie, which can be interpreted in two ways. It means either telling a lie, as if the poet is inviting us to join him in his falsehood about how the cherry tree, it is under the greenwood tree. Or it means lie down with me under the greenwood tree. Further, he calls the people to share his sentiments, to join him by saying, come hither, come hither, come hither. Now, hither is an old English word over here. Hither is old English word for the word here. That means poet is calling us by saying, come here, come here, come here. Next, he says, here shall he see no enemy, but winter and rough weather. Children, in our day-to-day life, we find so many enemies around us, isn't it? If you progress in your life, people are always jealous about you. They start backbiting and try every possible way to pull you down or hurt you. Because in this competitive world, everyone wants to gain success by some or the other means. It can be the wrong means also. So we find so many enemies around us. People fight, hurt each other. They use abusive and harsh language. So we do not find safe and sound place in this crowded city life. As we all know that nowadays humans are running behind money to achieve better life, and for that they are slogging day and night. We have become like machines without any feelings, ultimately forgetting to actually live our life. We try to find happiness in bigger things, whereas happiness can be found in smaller or simpler things also. For example, playing in the open ground, which is full of natural beauty, gives more happiness than playing in the play zone area, in a shopping mall. So, the poet is calling every one of us to be in nature, relax, and enjoy the natural, beautiful life, the simple life, away from city life, which is full of stress, children. He also assures us that you will not find any enemy here, except for winter and rough weather. That means they only have to face the trouble of winter and bad weather, which are common in the forest. Now, let us see some of the difficult words' meanings that we have come across in the first stanza. The first word is greenwood. Here, greenwood means forest filled with trees full of green leaves. That is greenwood. Second, we have seen the word merry, M-E-R-R-Y. Merry is an adjective. Okay, merry means full of joy or full of happiness. The next word is note. Now, note over here, it means it's a musical sound. Okay, now here this merry note is related to the bird's sound. The poet imitates the bird's singing. He also imitates the bird sound. The next word we have come across is hither. Hither is an old English word for come here or come over here. Okay, so these are the difficult words that we have seen. Next, we have come across some of the rhyming words. For example, tree, me. Next word is note, throat. Third is hither, weather. Then see, enemy. These are all rhyming words in the poem. Now let's check out the rhyme scheme. Do you know, children, what is rhyme scheme? You have to see the last word of every line or a sentence. Okay, here in the first line you will see which is the last word, tree. Now what we will do, we will give that particular word a name. So tree will be given name as A. Then below that you will find me word. So tree and me as having same sound. So me will also be given the name as A. Then below that you will find the word note. Note is different sound. Apart from tree and me, it is different sound. So we will give the name B. Throat. Throat and note matches. So we will give the sound name as B. Then hither word is there. Hither is again a different sound. So we will give it name as C. Then below that, C word, S-E-E-C. Here we will give sound A because tree, me, C matches, no? So we will give rhyming this word sound as A. Below that is enemy. Enemy, C, they all sound same. So again we will give the name A. And the last word in the first stanza is weather. So hither and weather matches. So we will give sound C. What we have given to hither, C. So weather will also have the same sound C. So what is the rhyme scheme of the first stanza? We can write the rhyme scheme of first stanza is A, B, B, C, A, C. This will be the rhyme scheme of first stanza. Now see, children, the next part of the poem, the next stanza of the poem, we will study in part 2 video. In that also, I'll be giving you some poetic devices and some figures of speech that has come across in this poem. That we will see in part 2 video of the same lesson. Till then, take care, learn the first stanza, थैंक यू चिल्ड्रन.